can make a dragon that's going to breathe imaginary fire. So this is going to be a simulation of what that might be like. We're going to start out by using this water bottle, and we chose a small water bottle because then you need less materials. And then you can go ahead and decorate your dragon. So the way it's going to work is you're imagining that this is the top, this is the mouth. You can either choose to draw on it. I have these stickers that I put on. So I would put my stickers on, or you could draw on it or tape something. So you can kind of see it's going to be the dragon laying like this with the mouth up. I cut out some wings, so maybe I'll put some wings and a tail. And you could just see how you would create your dragon. So now that you've made your dragon, here are some things you can use from around your house to see how we can make a simulation of how a dragon would breathe imaginary fire. So we're going to go ahead, I made sure to get this dish because it can get a little bit messy. So I'll put our dragon inside here. And then this is just baking soda. I'm adding about 1 tablespoon in. But again, as you work with this, you might see how it works with different levels and different amounts. So I'm using a funnel just to make it pouring easier right now. And then this is just dish soap. So I'm gonna add in dish soap. You can see it's going right into his mouth. And then the last thing, this would be whether you have vinegar or lemon juice, or we're using a citric acid solution. So we're going to add this one in last. So we'll do our countdown. 3, 2, 1, 0. We'll pour in our salsa and see what happens. Oh, you can see our dragon is breathing fire because its stomach got a little upset. The more you shake it, it'll actually do a lot, but it's really fun to see it go like this.
In the experiment you just conducted, we used baking soda or sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate is an amphoteric compound, and it reacts as an acid in the presence of a base, and it reacts as a base in the presence of an acid. In our reaction, since we use vinegar, which is acetic acid, it reacted as a base. So in this case, it was a weak base. And to get a more dramatic effect, we added dish soap, and then we added our vinegar. And what happens when we add our vinegar to the sodium bicarbonate, you have what is commonly called an acid-base reaction. It's a double displacement reaction where the sodium bicarbonate and acetic acid forms a carbonic acid and sodium acetate. And what happens is carbonic acid is not very stable, so it decomposes really quickly into carbon dioxide and water. And what you're seeing is the carbon dioxide that's forming from this reaction, and it's forming bubbles in the soap, and that's why it's coming up like this.